As mentioned in part one, part two of this week's content will focus on a step-by-step process of planning hymnody for any Mass. While not being exhaustive, this method will provide a framework and introduction to planning music for the liturgy. The first step to planning music for Mass is selecting a Mass setting. While this step will not be necessary every single instance where one is planning music for the Mass, it is still an important consideration because, as mentioned in Part 1, the acclamations within a Mass setting are the most important sung aspects of the Mass. The second step is to identify what scripture will be proclaimed at the Mass that is being planned. This is done by referencing the lectionary, or the book of readings assembled by the Church that groups readings together for each daily or each Sunday celebration. Within the U.S., an easy way to access the lectionary is through the United States Conference of Catholic Bishops website, or usccb.org. On the right-hand side of this site, you will find an interactive calendar with links to the readings appropriate for the date selected. Not only does this list include the first reading, second reading, and gospel, but the responsorial psalm as well. For those outside of the U.S., check with your bishop's conference to see if they have a digital lectionary available as well. If one is not available, the readings may always be found within the lectionary found in your church's sacristy. Once the readings for the Mass have been identified, step 3 charges the leader of music to pray through these readings, and I cannot stress this step enough. I find that the absence of prayer in planning music for Mass can lead to a disconnect or distance between the scripture that is heard and the music that is sung. By carefully reading and praying through the scripture, a music minister may easily identify topics or themes that emerge from the readings. These themes will be important in the next step. But again, the presence of prayer in encountering the readings can make all the difference between vibrant musical worship experiences and shallow, disingenuous liturgical singing. Once the readings have been prayed through by the one planning the music for Mass, two different resources may be checked to see what hymnody may directly correspond with the readings. The first of these resources is called the Scriptural Index, and it can be found in the back of nearly all major hymnals. Here, scripture passages are listed by book, and hymns and songs are listed next to the verses that are present within them. The Scriptural Index here is derived from GIA's Gather Hymnal 3rd Edition. Let's say that the Gospel for the Mass we were planning was derived from Luke chapter 5. We can easily see through this index the hymns in the hymnal that include references to that citation. So with a scriptural index in hand, a leader of music planning for the Mass may take the scriptural citations listed above the reading in the lectionary and check and see if songs are available through the hymnal that is being used. The second resource in this step is similar to the scriptural index, but instead of listing hymns for scripture verse reference, it catalogs songs through their thematic material. Here is where the topics that emerged in prayer come into play from step 3. Again, our example of a topical index is derived from GIA's Gather 3rd Edition. Keeping with the same gospel example, where Jesus calls the first disciples, we can examine the discipleship list in the topical index to see if any hymns correspond with what arose for us as we prayed the readings. Before concluding, let's review our 4-step process. First, we select or revisit a Mass setting that will help our congregation and community be successful in singing the acclamations proper to them. Next, we locate the readings assigned for the Mass we are planning by Holy Mother Church through an online lectionary source, such as usccb.org, or through our church's lectionary. Third, we pray through the readings ourselves and see what themes emerge as we encounter God in sacred scripture. And finally, we take what was heard in prayer to a scriptural and topical index of a hymnal to plan for our Mass. Most of the time, music will be filled into the following list of musical moments in the Mass. Be sure to revisit previous weeks if you are unsure of the function of each musical moment. Part 3, our final presentation for the course, will discuss some additional resources to reference when planning for Mass and will also describe the final project. Thanks for listening.